Hi, in this tutorial we are going to see how to assemble internal gears inside SpaceClim. We'll take an assembly in GrabCAD as shown here, and this is in the form of IGES file. So let's open the file. It's internal gears open. So it has two components. So to make it simpler, I'll just drag it to the root and delete the empty component. Okay, first things first, since we just have two components, we will make this as grounded. So that can be done using this anchor. So click on anchor, and as you can see, it's grounded now. Okay, now the second part is the defining gear condition between this and the outer gear. Okay, so for that we'll have to select two cylindrical surfaces, and we need to find out the pitch circle of both the gears. So how do we do that is simple. We just need to find the distance between the point center of these two. So we select, go to measure. So this is one, this is another. It says 20.0563. Okay, so this is the difference of, if you say R1 is the radius of the small gear, R2 is the radius of bigger gear. R2 minus R1 is 20.0563, and that is one equation we have. Another equation would be the ratio of the number of teeth. Okay, so to find out that, we'll select any of the gear protrusion. There's a selection tab here, and we say all coaxial protrusion. So it says 10 faces. We could have counted it manually as well, whereas in case of gears which have large number of teeth, so in this case we'll choose all equal radius cylinders, so they have 35 faces. So there is a ratio of 3.5. so this means R2, radius of bigger gear, by R1 is equal to 3.5. so we have two equations and we have two unknowns, R2 and R1. So that can be solved, and we can do it here as well. So let's select this, and we need to draw a circle, make it center of this. The radius is basically 20.0563. that was the difference in radius. Since this is the radius that we are going to do, we are going to define diameter. We'll multiply it with 2 and into number of teeth in this gear, so that is 10, divided by difference of the number of teeth. So that is 35 minus 10, that is 25. So this is the pitch circle of the first smaller gear. Okay, we create another circle, pitch circle for the outer gear. So click on this center. We can directly go and combine these two here, else we can as well go with the root I just mentioned. So in this case it would be 20.0563 into 2 into number of teeth in this particular gear, that is 35, divided by difference, that is 25. As you can see, it's we can go down and they are having a tangent, common tangent. Okay, that is the requirement for internal gears. Okay, once that is done, we select these two circles and control select, right click, go to construction on off. So this is basically like we need to create surfaces. Come to 3D view, 3D mode, and we need to pull this by orbit length so that we get some cylindrical surfaces. Okay, these surfaces are at the root assembly level. We need to move them to component level. So this surface, we move it here. so that if you select this, let's see. Okay, I think I'll have to move this here. This and this are in the same component. This will move here. Okay, so these two are the surfaces. Now, let's see what we need to do. We'll have to select this cylindrical surface, then second is this cylindrical surface, go to gear. Okay, so we have our gear condition defined, and then we need to make these two top surfaces planar. So we select these two and go to, there's something called as tangent. We could use align as well, so we would rather use tangent here. Click on tangent. So that is done. Okay, let's see if we have done it properly, which is not the case. I just click on move, and you can see that it's not rotating the way we want it to. Okay, that is because in internal gears we'll have to change the rotation direction. So right click on it, reverse rotation direction. So after that we try to move. Now the rotation direction is fine, but the gear is not moving as we had expected. So this is because of some issue that I'm yet to figure out. So to counter that, we'll assign another condition between these two cylinders surfaces and make them tangent. So by doing this, we now have a gear between two cylinders as well as a tangent between two cylinders. Okay, so let's go to move again, and this time we'll move it around, and as you can see, it's behaving as we had expected. Okay, so this is how you model a internal gear in space claim. Now I'll just quickly show you what SC Motion can do. Start SC Motion, which is a motion and dynamic simulation add-in. So in this case, we don't have to define any joints conditions here. It's already there. We'll just add gravity. So this is the y-axis. So we'll define gravity in the global y-axis, 9.8 meters per second square. So once that is done, let's simulate it. So we have we can see the action of gravity acting on the gear. Okay, so this wraps up our tutorial. So here we have seen how internal gears are to be modeled. So mainly we have a gear condition here which defines the number of what should be the ratio of the velocities, and we also need to have a tangent to make sure that it follows this path. Okay, thanks for watching.